Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss on the topic databases and information management. First of all, let us see learning outcome on this topic. At the end of this session, students will be able to describe how the problems of managing data resources in a traditional file environment are solved by database management system. First of all, organizing data in a traditional file environment. This slide actually describes the standard units of data stored by a computer in an information system. The smallest units common to all applications are bits and bytes. That is, a bit stores a single binary digit 0 or 1 and a byte stores a group of digits to represent a single character, number or other symbol. Some organizing data in a file environment uses terms that is field, record, file and data where the required data information should be stored in the traditional file environment. The data hierarchy. This diagram illustrates the hierarchy of data found in a database. It shows the student course file grouped with files on students personal histories and financial background to create a student database. In this diagram, there are data which are totally associated with the student course, where the records on the student's personal histories are stored and some their financial backgrounds are also created in the student database. What are the problems we face in traditional file environment? In this we discusses the problems in data management that occur in a traditional file environment. In a traditional file environment, different functions in the business, that is accounting, finance, HR, etc., maintain their own separate file and databases. So what kind of problems we face? First one is a redundancy. So here data redundancy stands for the data which is replicated in various positions in the databases. So data should not be replicated because data should occur only once in every databases. Then data inconsistency. Some attribute has different values which shows different things. So we can say it is a data inconsistency. Program data independence. When changes in a program requires change to data accessed by a program. Then lack of flexibility, then poor security and lack of data sharing and availability. So these are the problems we always face in a traditional file environment. The question occurs how to solve these problems in the traditional file environment. We go for traditional file processing. This diagram illustrates a traditional environment in which different business functions maintain separate data and application to store and access that data. The use of a traditional approach to file processing encourages each functional area in a corporation to develop specialized applications and files. Each application requires a unique data file that is likely to be a subset of the master file. These subsets of the master file lead to data redundancy and inconsistency, processing inflexibility and wastage of storage resources. So, in traditional file processing, we should consider all the problems before storing the data on the databases so that all the businesses and organizations run their database functions smoothly. Next point, the database approach to data management. So how the data should be placed in the particular area that is called as a database. What is database is? Database is a collection of data organized to serve many applications by centralizing data and controlling redundant data. Database management system performs interfaces between application programs and the physical data files where your application programs are connected to your data files. then separate logical and physical views of data. Database management system solves problems of traditional file environment, where the problems when we face for data processing. If we say what kind of database exists, so we take an example as a human resources database with multiple views. A single human resources database provides many different views of data depending on the information requirements of the user. Here are two possible views, one of interest in benefits specialist and one of interest to a member of the company's payroll department. This diagram illustrates what is meant by providing different logical views of data. The orange rectangle represents two different views in an HR database, one for reviewing employees' benefits, the other for accessing payroll records. The students can think of the green cylinder as a physical view, which shows how the data are actually organized and stored on the physical media. The physical data do not change, but a DBMS can create many different logical views to suit different needs of the users. Now we go for a relational database management system. It represents data as two-dimensional tables called relations or files. Each table contains data on entry and attributes. So here we consider table which is of grid of columns and rows. Rows we say tuples, which contains records for different entities. Fields we say columns, which represents attribute for entity. We say key field used to uniquely identify each record. Primary key, field in a table used for key fields where unique values are exist. Foreign key, primary key used in second table as lookup field to identify records from the original table. Here a table which consists of a relational database table which contains six fields: supplier number, then supplier name, then supplier street, supplier city, supplier state and supplier zip. So all the records are contained in the table. So here we show that record rows as a record, that is tuples, then column as attribute, or we can say fields, and then key fields are there, that is called as a primary key. In the primary key is here, supply number is the primary key where unique values are existed in this field. So the second table is part table, where part number, part name, part unit price and supply number are exist. Here part number is also a primary key which consists of unique values, and supplier number is a foreign key which we found this same field in the previous table, that is supplier table. So foreign key is used to look up a value in the original table. What kind of operations we perform on relational database management system? This describes how information is retrieved from a relational database. There are three operations. One is select, join, project, which are like programming statements and are used by the database management system developers. For example, looking at the last two slides showing the supplier and part table, you would be used for kind of an operation to show the parts records along with the appropriate supplier's name. So there are three operations of relational database. This includes the result from combining the select, join and project operation to create a subset of data. The select operation retrieves just those parts in the part table whose part number is 137 or 150. The join operation uses the foreign key of the supplier number provided by the part table to locate a supplier data from the supplier table for just those records selected in the select operation. Finally, the project operation limits the columns to be shown to be simplify the part number, part name, supplier number and supplier name, which is shown in the orange rectangle. After studying all these concepts, we move for the question. The question is, what are the entities that might be found in a university database? question is, what are the entities that might be found in a university database? So there is a university database. You have to write only the entities which are existed in the university database. The answer is, first one, student. Second, professor. Third, course. Fourth, department. And fifth, grade. These are all the entities which might be found in the university database. Now we go for object-oriented database management system. This discusses another type of database system where the organization wants to store multimedia or Java applets in a database. Then businesses, organizations choose this kind of database, that is object-oriented database management system. They want to use ODBMS in their business processes. These are the references for all these contents. Thank you.